السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
السلام.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. وبعد. We are still talking about ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى or remembering الله سبحانه وتعالى. As we said yesterday and the day before yesterday, ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى is very important. Why? Because it keeps you all the time attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It keeps you all the time aware of the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there. Your tongue is going to be all the time with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And consequently, as a result of that, the person is going to be admitted to paradise as we have been promised by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in so many places in the Quran is asking us to make dhikr to him subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remember him subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. And we said how we may make dhikr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah or according to this ayah, and how may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make dhikr to us. And then we said that it is as if the mu'min is supposed to be remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time, in all cases. Even if he would be interrupted by any of the obligatory parts, like the prayers, like Hajj, still he has to, you know, continue. He has to keep going and doing zikr after he would finish this obligatory part. And we quoted some ayahs that are proving this fact. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, says, فَإِذَا أَفَضْتُمْ مِنْ عَرَفَاتٍ after you are done with عَرَفَاتٍ, then فَذْكُرُوا اللَّهِ again. You make dhikr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again. And فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُمُ الصَّلَاةَ فَذْكُرُوا اللَّهِ after you are done with the prayer, again, make the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we're talking about the Jum'ah. فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةُ فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَابْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. So as if the case of the mu'min, the case of the follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is that he has to do the dhikr all the time. And this is the remembering of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you are getting out of your house, there is a special prayer that you have to say. When you are getting into your house, there is a special prayer that you have to say. When you are getting into the mosque, when you are getting out of the mosque, when you are getting into the toilet, when you are getting out of the toilet. So the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all the time with the person. And I think one time I mentioned when you are getting out of the toilet, you are saying ghufran. What does it mean ghufran? You are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive you. For what? According to the Muslim scholars, I have interpreted this dua, ghufran, Ya Allah, forgive me for not being able to make remembrance, to make dhikr while I am inside the toilet. So this is according to the interpretation of Muslim scholars, again, as if the case of the person has to make dhikr all the time to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yesterday, we talked about some of the benefits of making dhikr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we said the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just, you know, showering you with tranquility and peace. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. So once the person knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there, once the person all the time remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is just giving him peace and tranquility and comfort. whatever powerful person or whatever powerful being is not going to work as long as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there. As long as I have this kind of strong conviction that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who is bringing me good, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is bringing me bad things. وَيَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will decide something wrong for you, something bad for you, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only who can lift it from you. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides something good for you, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who can bring it to you. So this again brings you peace and tranquility. Nothing ever is going to happen to you except with the will and of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we said another benefit of making a dhikr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that you are going to be protected against the shaytan. And we quoted the ayahs and the hadith, and Sayyidina Ibn Abbas, Abdullah Ibn Abbas, when he said, you know, the shaytan is all the time with human being. When he stays away from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he forgets to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so shaitan starts to whisper to him. فَإِذَا ذَكَرَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى جَفَى. When this person, you know, remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the shaitan just runs away. Some other benefits of making dhikr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as explained by Muslim scholars is that, as we quoted again yesterday, let me just put the things that we have quoted yesterday to make the connection, so as to make the connection between what we have said yesterday and some other benefits that we're going to deal today, that it is the reason for you to be surrounded and protected by the angels, and this is according to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Another benefit is that this is the thing that is going to be the reason for you to be admitted to paradise. And we quoted this incident in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was just passing by somebody who was just planting something, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, should I not tell you something, that if you would say, you would be getting as many of trees as of the words of this thing? And they said, yes, ya Rasulullah. And they said what? You remember? Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. For each word you are saying of this kind of prayer or dua or dhikr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are going to get a tree in paradise, inshallah. Another thing is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just priding. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is boasting whenever there is a circle of people remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, either individually or in a group. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, as this story that is narrated by Sayyidina Muawiyah, when he was just passing by some people in the masjid, and he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked them, why are you staying in the masjid? They said, we are staying because we are just remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are making dhikr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked them one more time, and they said, are you waiting in the masjid just for this reason? And they said, ya Rasulullah, this is just the reason for which you are staying in the masjid. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just boasting in front of the angels. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, look at my servants, they are just kept themselves in the masjid so as to glorify my name, so as to, you know, praise me, so as to thank me, so as to show gratitude to me. So another benefit is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is boasting and priding in front of the angels with the people who are making remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad one time was asked by somebody to give him some advices. And he gave him five advices. The last of these advices, you need to keep remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a way of removing all kinds of sayyiat that you have done. And as a way of getting you protected against the sayyiat. He, radiallahu anhu, told him that you need to keep your tongue again. This is the very advice of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he was asked by one of his companions, ya Rasulullah, how, يعني, I think we quoted this hadith several times, when he said, ya Rasulullah, thaqulat alayya shara'i', يعني, the regulations are very, you know, many to me, and it's not easy for me to count all of them. So tell me of something that's easy, I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna be sticking to it. فأنبئني بشيء أتشبث به. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يزال لسانك رطبا من ذكر الله. Just keep your tongue wet of the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The question here, and this question was asked to Imam Ibn Taymiyyah when he was asked, which is good for the person, to make istighfar or to make tasbih? To say astaghfirullah al-azim, astaghfirullah al-azim, astaghfirullah al-azim, or to say subhanallah, subhanallah, subhanallah. He radiallahu anhu said, according to the case of the person himself, and he gave him this example. If you do have this clothes that is dirty, which is better, to perfume it or to wash it? To perfume it, right? Or to wash it? If it is dirty, you need first to wash it first.
And then perfume it.
You need to get it clean first and then perfume it. And this is the example that he had given to the person who asked him this question. If the person is full of sayyiat, wal'ayyazu billah, somebody who had committed, this is his attitude. He is just, you know, he is a kind of person who does not care about committing the sayyiat, and he is committing just sayyiat all the time. It's better for him just to clean himself from the sayyiat through istighfar, through saying astaghfirullah al-azim, astaghfirullah al-azim, astaghfirullah al-azim. And later on, it's going to be better for him just to make the tasbih to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you do have a dirty clothes, you need just to wash it first to make it clean, and after that, you perfume it. And this is the example when he said, if you have this piece of clothes, you need the soap first, and later on, you bring the bukhur and ma'il ward for the clothes. And this is the case of the person. If he is kind of somebody who does not care again about committing the sayyat, it's better for him to wash himself, to clean himself from the sayyat, and later on it's better for him to make the istighfar. You know how easy it is for us brothers and sisters to get close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just to say la ilaha illallah, just to say subhanallah wa bihamdihi subhanallah al-azim, just to say subhanallah wa alhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wa allahu akbar. And you know, we do have so many beautiful hadiths of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is asking us to start it. As I'm always saying, we need to start. This is the hardest thing. Once I'm getting myself used to istighfar, I'm going to do it the rest of my life. Once I'm getting myself to the adhkar as-sabah and the adhkar al-masa, there are certain kinds of prayer that I need to say in the morning. There are certain kinds of prayers that I need to say in the evening. If I am getting myself used to these kinds of adhkar, it's going to be with me the rest of my life. But the difficult thing is that the start. I need just to start. So let us make use of this opportunity of being in the month of Ramadan, and let us start a new page with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are just preoccupied with the dunya. And this is something which really brings us down in our relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this hadith said, subhanallah, يعني it's very beautiful hadith of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hadith Qudsi. يَبْنَ آدَمْ وَرْيَ عَبْدِي خَلَقْتُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامِ وَلَمْ أَعْيَ بِخَلْقِهِنَ أَيُعْيِينِي رَغِيفٌ أَسُوقُهُ إِلَيْكَ. يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this hadith is just asking us. Initially he said, عَبْدِي, my servant, I have created heavens and earth just in 6 days. And I never felt tired because of doing that. Am I gonna feel tired if I would just provide you with a piece of bread? Am I gonna feel tired because of that? So this is the thing that we need really to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to have this trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is our problem. This is the problem. Once we do have this kind of trust, again, it's gonna take us to the tuma'nina. Alladhina amanu wa tatma'innu qulubuhum bi dhikrillah. Whatever is happening to you, this is just by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But again, we need to rely completely on the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَيُعِينِي رَغِيفٌ أَسُوقُهُ إِلَيْهِ. Am I going to be tired because of a piece of bread I'm going to provide you, while He subhanahu wa ta'ala had created heavens and earth on 6 days and He never felt tired because of that. So, and one of the good things that you need to say whenever you do have any kind of problem is that حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. And again, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, you know, again in a way to strengthen our relation with Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, إن الله سبحانه وتعالى لا يلوم بالعجز. فابلو من نفسك الجهد. فإن عجزت وغلبت فقل حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to blame you for something that you do not know. But you need again to seek knowledge. You need to search for knowing religious things. This is what this means by فَبْلُوا مِن نَفْسِكَ الْجُهْدِ. You need just to do your best. This is what you are asked to. Just to do your best in order to be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But and if you, خلاص, if you fail, just to say, حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is my sustainer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is my aid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that I am relying on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one I'm having the trust on. حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. And but you know, again, we need just to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we have to start. We have to start. We have to do our best. I'm recalling, and I'm going to conclude with this story of Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab. Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab, one time he was in the Kaaba and he found some people from Yemen, and they were just a circumambulation around the Kaaba. They were making the tawaf around the Kaaba, and he asked them, and they were begging people. They were just making tawaf and they did not have any kind of work, you know, and they were just begging people for money. And Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab, he said, asked them, who are you? And they said, we are al-mutawakkiluna ala Allah. He said, no, you are not al-mutawakkiluna ala Allah. They said, we are the people who are relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab said, you are not the mutawakkilun. You are the mutawakkilun. It's the same, but we're just adding the long vowel after the vowel. You are al-mutawakkilun. Al-mutawakilun means people who are just relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they are doing nothing. They are just relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sitting home. They are just relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and just worshipping Allah, and they are not working to earn their livelihood. So he said, you are not the real people who are relying, who are not really relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are the mutawakilun, which is there, right? So al-mutawakkilu ala Allah huwa alladhi yarmi al-habba thumma ba'da dhalika yad'u Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The person who is really mutawakkil ala Allah, the one who is relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the one he has to take part. He has to do something. The one who is just planting the seed, and the result is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the real mutawakkil. So the mutawakkil is the one who is relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he is looking for work. He is working hard. He is, you know, trying his best in order to be as close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so as to be successful in the dunya and the akhirah as well. But if somebody says, I am just relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stay home, this is not the real mutawakkil ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather all of us as He subhanahu wa ta'ala gathered us in the dunya, to gather us all in the akhirah, in the highest place in paradise with النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. اللهم تقبل صيامنا وصلاتنا وركوعنا وسجودنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل أول يومنا هذا صلاحا وأوسطه فلاحا وآخره نجاحا. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وجزاكم الله خيرا.
الله يجزاك الله.
Oh, my goodness.